Matt Wave from IBC Boilers here, and today we're going to be running through the procedure on how to replace the heat exchanger gasket on our HCDC style boiler. So before you get started, the number one thing with any gas appliance is you want to make sure that the gas supply is turned off. So first of all, we're going to go and remove the gas valve from the boiler. We'll just grab a wrench here and open them up. Make sure you hold on to the gas valve. Now when removing the gas valve, there is an orifice with an O-ring on there. So make sure that you keep this aside for a reinstall. Now we'll go ahead and we'll take the vent off. You just loosen up this little O-ring in here, give it a twist, and it comes right out. Now what you'll want to do next is you're going to want to disconnect these connects up here to the fan. Put them aside, like so. And then we're going to go ahead and take off the nuts for the heat exchanger. Okay, so now that we got the last bolt out, we can go ahead and pull up the heat exchanger. You have to jimmy it a little bit, give it a little bit of moving to get it out, but it is fairly simple. It just pops out just like this. And then you're going to see the gasket that is around the heat exchanger, and we're going to be replacing that. Just grab one of the corners here, and it pops right off. And we can go ahead and put the heat exchanger aside for now. Now make sure you inspect the gasket for any cracks, any compression, or any signs of damage whatsoever on the new one before you put it back in. So while we have the heat exchanger cover off, might as well take a look at the heat exchanger and see if it needs to be cleaned or whatnot. The tool you're going to want to use is a nylon bristled brush. You definitely do not use a stainless steel brush. We don't want to scratch the surface. And you're just going to run the brush down through here. Just make sure it's clean. Use the nice little scrubs like that. And all the debris will fall down here and it'll fall down into the condensate pan, which is this right here. And this can easily be removed and dumped out and washed out and put back in. While we have the heat exchanger cover off, let's check the gapping on the boiler and make sure it's going to spark correctly. Here at IBC, we have a little gapping tool. You just request it and we can give you one. You're going to see there's a straight line here, and then there's a groove right here. And how this works is you run it up the heat exchanger like this, along the walls, and you want it to stop. Then you turn it around where the groove is, run it up there, and it should pass right by it, just like that. So that's a good gap. That's a good gapped igniter. Once again, this way where it stops, flip it over, and it goes right through. That's a good gapping. Okay, so now that we looked at the condition and the cleanliness of the heat exchanger and we made sure the gapping is good, we're gonna go ahead and replace the gasket. Now, once again, make sure you inspect it for any cracks, any compressions, anything that looks out of the ordinary. You never wanna put in a bad gasket. So this is fairly simple. You're just gonna run it around here. There's a groove around the heat exchanger, you can clearly see. And you're just gonna run it around, fit it in nice, just like that. Make sure she's sitting in the grooves nice and easy. That's looking pretty good there. And that's it. We're gonna go ahead and check it before we actually put the bolts back in as well, just to make sure it's not compressing on any gaskets as well. So then we'll just go ahead and turn that around. Reinstall the heat exchanger cover, same way you pulled it out. Just like that. And then I'll go grab the bolts and we'll install the heat exchanger cover. Okay, so we'll tighten up that last bolt. And while we're here, I'd like to mention that you do want to reinstall the bolts on a cross pattern like you would on an automobile tire. You want to make sure you don't have any compression or squishing of the gaskets around the edges, which could potentially have gas leaks. So you want to make sure it's nice and even, the bolts are on nice and even, and now we can go ahead and reinstall our gas valve. Now, it's easy if you slide her on the bottom there. You can just bring this nut up, super simple. Now remember, we had that orifice that had that O-ring when we took the gas valve off. You want to make sure you reinstall that between the gas line and just the gas valve here at the top. Pull down this nut here. Tighten those up. And next thing we'll do is we will go and connect the line to the fan and reinstall the vent, and we're good to go. Okay, so now that we have the gas valve all buttoned up, we can go ahead and install the signal wiring harness from the control to the fan. The 120 volt going to the fan. Now we can go ahead and reinstall the vent pipe. It goes in the same way it came out. Get a little twist in there. You're gonna wanna pull it down until it stops. Now there is a gasket here. You're gonna wanna bring that down. Put it in there nice and flush. Then you can bring down the plastic nut, quarter turn, and we're good to go. So we've looked at the cleanliness of the heat exchanger. We've replaced the heat exchanger gasket. We looked at the gapping on the igniter. We all buttoned up, we're good to go, and fire it up.